Do you have swallowing problems like food getting stuck in your throat when you're eating? I'm Kasondra, I'm a speech therapist, and today I'm going to show you three swallow exercises to help strengthen your swallow.
Speech secrets.
Dysphagia, the medical term for swallowing problems, is common with people who've had stroke, Parkinson's, traumatic brain injury, or even as you age. Swallow exercises are used to strengthen the swallow in the same way that a physical therapist would give exercises to strengthen other muscles of the body. To know exactly what is impaired or weak about your swallow, you would work with a speech therapist. These exercises are most effective when combined with a full treatment plan. One thing I always do with people I work with before doing swallow exercises is show why we're doing them and a little bit on how the swallowing works. Quick look at some of the structures involved with swallowing. These are the lips, the teeth, the roof of your mouth, the tongue. In the back area, this is called your pharynx. And here is the trachea. The trachea goes down to your lungs. The vocal cords sit right on top of the trachea. The tube towards the back of the neck is your esophagus, where the food should go when you swallow. And when you swallow, this structure called the epiglottis comes down and covers the trachea like a little flap to protect food from going down into your lungs and making sure it goes into your esophagus down to your stomach. The first exercise, called the Masako maneuver, targets the strength of the back of your tongue, known as the base of tongue. When you swallow, the back of your tongue moves towards the back of your throat and helps to propel food down into your esophagus. If this is weak, you might experience residue between your swallows. For this exercise, stick out your tongue, hold it between your teeth, and swallow without moving your tongue. If this feels too difficult, don't stick your tongue out quite so far, or you can tilt your head downwards when in that position and swallow with your head tilted downwards. If you have a hard time triggering the swallow between repetitions, you can moisten your mouth with some liquid, but never do this exercise while you're actually eating or drinking. The next exercise is called the Mendelsohn maneuver. To understand how this exercise works, put your hand on your Adam's apple or your larynx and swallow. What did you notice? You should have noticed that your Adam's apple moves upwards and outwards. We call this hyolaryngeal elevation and excursion. This movement is essential for being able to close off your airway and allow food to pass into your esophagus and not go into your trachea, go into your airway. To do this exercise, first you're going to swallow enough so that your larynx moves upwards, and then you're going to hold it in that position for a couple seconds. Then complete the swallow. Let me show you. When your larynx is up, it's normal that you can't breathe or can't take a breath in, and that's because the epiglottis is covering your airway. So don't worry. This exercise works your submandibular hyolaryngeal muscles, again, the ones that help to bring your larynx up. Before we get to the last exercise, please press like, subscribe to my channel so I can keep making videos like this, and let me know what type of topics you'd like to see more on. The last exercise we'll do laying face up, so I'm gonna bring you over to my table. This last exercise is called the shaker. It also promotes the upward and outward movement of the larynx. To do this exercise, lay flat on a table, on the ground, on your bed. Keep your shoulders touching the surface below you throughout. Lift only your head so that you can see your toes. I like to use the cue of keeping an orange or a ball under your chin. You're going to hold this position for 30 seconds. And once you've completed that, take a rest. And then do 10 consecutive repetitions. And those repetitions are just a place to start. You want to work up to being able to hold that position for up to a minute and doing up to 30 repetitions with breaks, of course. Make sure to talk to your speech therapist about what exercises are right for your swallow problems. If you're finding this exercise a bit too physically strenuous, because it does have a tendency to work other muscles in your neck, you can check out the chin tuck against resistance exercise in my swallow video 1, and that targets similar musculature in a little less physically strenuous way. Hope you found this helpful. Thanks for watching, and be kind to yourself.